If you're at all compelled about the longevity and expansion of the Mr. T Show, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Links below.
Hey there, fools. Big T here, and I'm back again with another video. And I just kind of want to revisit a point I made in a previous video. Now that the Switch is doing as well as it's doing, with all the great sales, the record-breaking sales it continues to keep having, software and hardware-wise, I just wanted to revisit a point I made some time ago when I talked about, I think it was probably a little more than a year ago, actually. Pretty sure it was before the Switch launched, where I talked about definitive, I want to say this was actually summer of 2016. There was a lot of, people were disheartened with Nintendo at that point. Wii U was pretty much dead. There was not a lot of talk around Wii U at that time. People were talking NX. NX rumors were at an all-time high, and people had pretty much moved on to the new hardware. It was still NX at that time. We hadn't learned about the Switch name and all that stuff. And there was just a lot of rumors, a lot of YouTubers, especially news channels, newstubers, gaming newstubers, were talking about, what the NX needed, to be successful. And I just kind of just shot all that down. I was like, no, there's no definitive reasons for any console's success. And I just went over all these different consoles, and I laid out a pretty good case, I thought. I did a video where I was just shooting me talking off the cuff, and I showed a bunch of different consoles and explained why they did well and why they didn't. Like, Dreamcast, Saturn, GameCube, PlayStation 3, and I was just showing the differences, and there's no definitive reason why a console does well. And I did that because a lot of people were talking about, for the NX to be successful, it needs this, all these things to be successful. And basically people were saying, without saying, the Switch, or excuse me, at the time the NX, basically needed to be a PlayStation 4. The funny thing is that people aren't that creative in their thinking around these things usually, but they think what they're saying is so poignant when it's not. It's like, they think, let's see, the PlayStation 4 is successful, so I'm just gonna name off everything that the PlayStation 4 does, and that is what Nintendo needs to do with the Switch, or again the NX at the time. So it had to be super powerful, had to have a great online infrastructure, had to have, third-party support out the way, all this stuff, that people pointed to. Basically, again, using the PS4 as their reference to why the Switch or the NX, what it needed to do to be successful. And NX checks almost none of those boxes. Almost none of those boxes. The power box, it doesn't check. The online infrastructure doesn't check. It doesn't have a lot of that stuff. Third party, yeah, there's third party on Switch, potentially more than what the Wii U had, but currently not really, as far as like big games from third parties. Wii U had more of those at this point, and the Switch doesn't have those yet. And we all believe those are coming. I'm not saying that that's not the case, but what I'm saying is, when the Switch was selling, we didn't have, while the Switch is selling, I should say, we don't have that kind of support that the Wii U even had. So I'm just pointing that out, not to say that the Switch won't have it, but I'm just saying, like, all those boxes were not checked with the Switch, and this thing is selling better than Wii at this point. It may be doing weaker than Wii was in Europe, I'm not really sure. It's pretty close, and like I said, it doesn't check any of those boxes, the same way the Wii didn't check any of those boxes. The Wii didn't come out and try to compete graphically with the 360 and the PS3. The Wii did its own thing, went in its own direction. It didn't have this third-party support. It had a lot of third-party support, but it didn't have the traditional third-party support from the games that were coming out on those consoles. And here we are, again, with the Switch. It's doing the same thing. and it's selling gangbusters. And it's not even to the same audience. It'd be one thing if it was selling, you know, the Switch was selling to, you know, quote unquote grandmas and grandpas and, you know, soccer moms and all the stuff that the Wii was accused of selling to. It's not selling to those, that crowd. It's selling to the average core gamer for the most part. And because of its form factor, unlike the PlayStation 4, Xbox One, or unlike the 360 and PS3, because of its form factor, people buy multiple ones for the household. Like if you got some kids, you will end up getting more than one Switch, unlike you would do for a PlayStation or an Xbox, you know, because of its form factor. You can take it anywhere. So like every kid in the house wants one. Like I have one, my son, I just bought him one for Christmas, and my daughter wants one now. You know, she's 5. I don't know. She doesn't spend as much time playing video games, so I don't know if I want to make that investment for her. But I might at some point, and that's the dilemma, if you will, that a lot of families face, you know, parents face, is that, you know, it's not just they're going to share one per kid. Every kid wants one because of the personal nature of the Switch and its portability. So it's really cool to see this. And yeah, you should go check that video out, because, you know, I make little jokes about me being Negro Domus or whatnot. And then something comes along and proves it. So here you go. There was no definitive reasons that Switch would sell as far as matching up to what PS4 or Xbox One did. It's doing its own thing and it's selling way better than those consoles in their first year. And it's just very cool to be proven right. And you know, there was a good amount of people that were against what I was saying in that video, but looks like I was right. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about definitive reasons for failure or success. And go check that video out if you haven't seen it. Like I said, I think it was summer of 2016, in the dead of Nintendo Wii U. So go check that video out. I will leave a link to that as well. Again, thanks for watching and listening, and I'll see you fools next time. Peace out.